You know the song, I have given you authority to tread on snakes and scorpions and to overcome the power of the enemy. Nothing shall harm. Was taken from this particular text. It's in Luke's Gospel chapter 10. When disciples came back to bring their reports to Jesus of how Satan submitted to them and how demons were subjected to the authority, and then at the name of Jesus, every knee bowed. So they were happy and rejoicing. And Jesus said, don't just rejoice over this. Rejoice rather than that your names are written in the kingdom of heaven. Now, there's something that caught my attention in this gospel text in a very spectacular way today. It is the fact that Jesus lived a very special life. So that one caught my attention today, the kind of life Jesus lived and in his dealings and relationship with disciples and people around him. The special life Jesus lived was the life in God that Jesus lived. Jesus was always in the presence of the Father and the presence of the Holy Spirit. He never left the presence of God. That is why you could see him talking to the disciple 1 minute, the next minute he's talking to God. Next minute is filled with the Holy Spirit. We are told today that Isaiah talking to them, he was telling them, do not rejoice that Satan submits to you. Rejoice rather than your names are written in heaven. As I was talking to them, the next minute, he talks to the Father. But in the same hour, he rejoiced in the Holy Spirit and said, I thank you, Father, Lord of heaven and of earth, that you have hidden these things from the wise and understanding and revealed them to infants. And he says, yes, Father, for such was your gracious will. All things have been delivered to me by my Father, and no one knows the Son except the Father, or who the Father is except the Son, and anyone to whom the Son chooses to reveal him. Then he told the disciples again. Said to them, blessed are your eyes. You see, the kind of life Jesus lived. He lived that life in God. He was always in the presence of the Father. When I looked at this morning, I noticed that Jesus was very conscious of the fact that he was always with God. That shows he had faith per excellence, super faith. He knew always was with God. Not like us, 1 minute we think, we don't even remember. Sometimes we don't even remember our presence of God. We do things, we fight, we insult, we do all kinds of evil, we don't remember. But Jesus was always conscious of the fact that he was with God. Not just that, he was conscious. He knew he was with God and in God all of the time. And even though sometimes he went to a little place to pray, but he didn't need to go there to talk to God. As he just told the disciples, just talk to God, come back to the disciples and talk to God while he is there. He was a very special person. And he had that special relationship with God that he can talk to God anytime. And that is what he wants us to have. Even if you can have a little bit of what Jesus had, we can always remember that we're in the presence of God. If you remember that, you will not cheat, you will not fight, you will not curse, you will not backbite. All the evil things will do it. If you remember you are with God, God is with you. That every time you stand, God is with you. You will not do any evil. Because we will never ever try because no, God is there. But when we do evil, we forget. We put God behind. That's what we do. And that's one special thing I think which we need to learn from this text today. That Jesus had a very special life. He was a very special personality. He had that relationship with God that was also special. And he knew God's presence was with him always. He was always conscious of that. And for that reason, he did things that were holy all of the time. Can we just imitate this? Can we just for one day say, let me just say one whole day, I say, I'm in the presence of God that day. And whatever I'm doing, whatever I'm saying, whatever I'm eating, whatever I'm dancing, anywhere I am, whatever it is that I do, I know God is there. If we all know this, the world will be a better place. The world will be changed if we all know. Those who embezzle money will not embezzle money. Those who steal will not steal. Those who fight will not fight. Those who curse will not curse. Those who tell lies will not tell lies. Because you know that God is there. He's with you. It's not just you think he is, but you feel his presence. God is already here. Do you feel his presence? He's already here. All you have to do is to open up your heart For he's already here. God bless you in our hearts through Christ our Lord.
Amen.